all challenging in different ways, you know. So there's ones that spring to mind when you're thinking of like emotional scenes that I always find very challenging, because when you're going into an emotional scene, I put a lot of pressure on myself about like being able to deliver the exact emotion that you think the character would be going through, and that's exactly what you shouldn't do. You should go into it just like open. And so I would say that like for me, highly emotional scenes I find trickier. But then of course there's like fight scenes that are physically difficult, and then you know, sometimes like you go a line and it's supposed to be funny and you're like, I don't know how I'm gonna make this funny. You're like trying very hard. So I don't know, what would you say is your biggest scene? I mean your the one
that
comes.
I think the one that we really talk through was probably the Netflix cut scene. You say the first one? But yeah, so in where this season, what's so lovely is you really see Nicole kind of break down, and we really need to come into that role. And I think that's such a strength for them as a couple, is they seem to, like, when one goes this way, the other compensates really well.
Yeah, very well said. I concur.
Hi. First, I want to say I love you guys, and I want to know how it's friendly to you guys to be in contact with everyone from all around the world. And second, I want to ask for Dom if she can sing for us.
Scene in episode 3 that that where they do have a conversation about vulnerability and fear, that I think is quite lovely.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about?
That I think is quite nice. But they do agree, I mean, on the show, we just unfortunately all the team have to move the story forward and they end up wanting characters, but I agree with it would be nice to see some more of them. So hopefully you get a little bit more of that season 3.
Thank you, I'm so sorry for.
No, it's a great question.
Thank you.
Holy man. I grew up in China, and I have never experienced cold like this.
Way less in season one and two as well. Like, we were like, sometimes going like, how are you doing in the cold? And then season three was like, how are you doing in the cold? Playing this is something, it's the ultimate Canadian experience, because we shot in some locations where we had to ski-do in this year. So I have a really great video of Melanie and I on the back of the ski-doo, because you couldn't drive, because there was so much snow and ice, you couldn't, so everything had to come on a toboggan, attached to the ski-doo, and go up the hill. And then when we get to the top, there's an ice fishing tent. This is not a joke. There's an ice Canadian ice fishing tent with an electric heater inside of it for all of us to go into. But our crew has like electric current clothing. I don't know if anyone's ever worked in cold before, but it has a battery pack. And they're outside all day, like they don't get a tent. So it's, our crew's incredible.
I can relate to that.
Can you? Yeah. Have you worked inside?
I was in cold in my house
station. Oh, okay. It's, yeah.
How do you feel to interpret a 100% lesbian character? Because normally there's like bisexual characters or lesbians that have been with men, but you are 100%.
100%. There's a display case that I bought for a soul to live in my body. This sounds weird when I say it, but I just feel so, I can't believe it. It doesn't feel like me sometimes when I look at all that and all this, and I just feel like a tiny piece of it, but I feel extremely proud and forever changed, and my life will never be the same, and she'll always be proud.
Oh my God! I'll be like very active online and then I'll disappear for a week and I have a in that way too sometimes because like, because I do believe not enough artists, I've always loved business and I almost went to business school. So I do feel a sense of I want to build something for me that no one can take away from me. And I have a hard time being an actor sometimes because I feel like so much of my career is based on somebody else liking me. And that sucks. So I would struggle to build something for myself that I can always have as my business and what I want to see in the world and that no one can take away from me, but remaining authentic, always checking in, being careful about what brands I might promote or who I want to partner up with, if I want to partner with somebody and do something creatively, or just make my own short film and use it as a platform to get my creative work out. I think it's like an ever-changing target for me, and I'm constantly have a vision of having with myself to check back into why are you doing this and what does it mean for you in the bigger picture as someone who wants to, you know, put their message out but make sure to themselves. I don't want to sell out, so it's a constant balance, I think.
Thank you.